an underwhelming rookie BattleBot versus Slammo, aka
the worst robot in robot combat history.
This is a fight for redemption. Still, unbeknownst to Doom, it was hardly the genesis of a war for survival. Doom was doomed. Having been accepted into BattleBots World Championship 7 as a full competitor, the bot appeared promising. However, with such an ambitious design and lacking practical BattleBots building experience and knowledge, Doom was ill-prepared for the main season, resulting in a swap to an alternate slot, where it fought once and lost, as compared to the 4-plus fights all main competitors received. Lessons learned, reality realized, things were dim for Doom. Enter BattleBots Proving Grounds, a superb opportunity for all BattleBots contenders to experiment with and refine designs in deadlocked heavyweight combat. For Doom, there is no better path to success than utilizing Proving Grounds as much as possible to develop the machine and restore its reputation to compete in BattleBots World Championship 8. Regardless of the pain and consequences that ensue, Doom has decreed to achieve maximum potential. Following a reckless series of fights at Robogames 2023, Doom is now slated to fight Slammow in just over a 4-week time period. Doom was technically unfinished at the time of Robogames and competitively suffered as a result. However, through suffering, lessons were learned. Enough lessons, in fact, to prompt a structural redesign of Doom's inner frame and overhauled electronics packaging. Primary causes of Doom's Robo-Suffering at Robogames include weight, center of gravity, reliability, and electronics packaging. Weight especially, since that was 90% the reason explosive lithium polymer batteries made their way to the outside of the robot. A bulletproof armor panel which doubled as a battery case retainer was essentially replaced with duct tape. The other 10% was the absence of two zip ties that were supposed to hold the battery cases together in the first place. Goes to show how catastrophic unforeseen weight fluctuations may be. And things could have been much worse if not for the significant changes made to the arm transmission and armor assemblies before RoboGames. I will cover those improvements in future videos. Such crucial issues take major steps to resolve, especially when money is a factor. Rebuilding the frame to reduce weight and lower center of gravity ain't cheap. Alternatively, the existing frame would have to be extensively modified to accomplish this. Potentially risky, as if things go wrong anywhere along the way, frame components could be essentially destroyed and rendered completely useless, not to mention the numerous unused holes from previous modifications. The frame was not designed to be modified this much, or at all. However, Doom's decree shall advance. Apt DOOMTRONICS, the electrical packaging system of Doom, was about to get an extreme overhaul. Electronics packaging shall antagonize me no more. I mean, if I must parametrically model my wires, so be it. An arduous task for, hopefully, what would be the end to the Doom wires. No expense spared on this design. I'll model pockets and mounting systems for the individual antennas of the receivers if I must. Channels for all wires to conform to, and an infinite amount of zip-tie harnessing positions. No more second guessing. The only option is for it to work flawlessly. With that resolved, let's see what's up with the spin-up system. At the time, it's believed it doesn't work because it isn't good enough, so make it better. Perhaps try a different approach. First stage chain transmission seems like a better option. Belts just haven't been doing it lately. The chain would completely reduce excessive spin-up slippage unlike belts. However, more power must be resisted by the spinner motors upon weapon impact due to the reduction in clutch capabilities. And with some additional changes, Doom is barely ready in time for Slammo. Despite helping with the improvements for these fights, my team completely flaked out on me at this event. Something to do with caring about their grades and taking their finals seriously, but not to worry, BattleBots was generous enough to replace them with actors. But now was the time to focus on something I had dreaded for so long, passing safety, the barrier for Doom's entry into World Championship 7. mostly worked on minor tweaks here and there for the time before the first fight. I also found out that Doom's weight was dramatically reduced to 231 pounds, 19 under the 250 limit. I was shocked at how much lighter it had become and thought this would be a problem in the fight, but it just so happens that Slammo clocked in at around the same number. And speaking of Slammo, all this time I had focused on making general improvements, but not worrying enough about Doom's opponent. You know, the seasoned BattleBots veteran I'd be fighting to the death this weekend. Now, Slammo doesn't have a particularly impressive record, but Doom doesn't particularly have a record. Got shredded, blown up, tipped over, won a pushing match, and three of those weren't even at BattleBots. The feeling before fighting with your own BattleBot in an official match is unlike anything else I've ever experienced. The uncertainty is immense, and the anxiety is immeasurable. 1,000+ hours of work, thousands of dollars of money, and the biggest sacrifices I've ever made, all packaged into what at most is a 3-minute fight. It's doom or die.
It's the proving ground.
Fight.
Let the bot battle begin. Wow.
Whoa,
that's a fast bot. Oh my goodness. Doing what Slammow!
Oh!
Big time!
Good job by Slammo there. Such a smashing hit to get things rolling.
He's a grapple bot and he absolutely grabbed a hold there. Oh.
Struggling a little bit to get back on his feet.
Stop spinning. Is he able? Done.
All right, Doom, I gotta see movement.
Come on,
I gotta count you out, Doom.
I wanna get in there and
okay.
Grab a hold of him.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Knockout! Winner, Slammo!
For every failure, there is a lesson learned. And for every application of a lesson, Doom shall make progress towards full potential. And this being said, failure shall feel a bright future for Doom. Therefore, I guess you can say that for Doom to become Doom itself, Doom must first conquer Doom itself. Learn from it. Destroy it. Become it.